Hey guys, what's going on? It's Jimmy over from Movie Death Blows. How are you? I said I was going to be doing a lot of videos, original content, in the weeks to come, so this is our second video. I wanted to do this one on Sunday, but I didn't get a chance to it. There was a bunch of family stuff going on. But this is going to be dedicated to Bill Paxton, the late Bill Paxton. It was his birthday on Sunday the 17th. He would have been 64 years old. He passed away unexpectedly in 2017, in February of 2017. So this is going to be dedicated to Bill. As everybody knows here, I think you've seen the meme going around. I've shared it plenty of times. Bill Paxton is the only actor to ever be killed by an alien, a Terminator, and a Predator. So, in Terminator, he was killed by Arnold in the beginning.
Nice night for a walk.
Wash day tomorrow. Nothing clean, right?
Nothing clean, right.
Hey, I think this guy's a couple cans short of a six-pack.
You're close. Give them to me. Now.
Fuck you, asshole!
In Aliens, his character was, sucked into the grates and, had the eggs implanted in him and was presumably killed. I mean, you don't see his death on screen, but you can infer from what happened that he died. Predator, I think he played Officer Jerry Lambert, and in that train sequence, you get to see him, just get ripped out of the train, and then I don't remember if they actually show the Predator actually killing him. You more or less hear his screams, and then you see his bones, I think, or something along those lines.
Keep walking! Come on, you two! Ravenous! Ravenous!
Come on, motherfucker!
What you can do?
Let's dance!
Now, every year when this comes up, I get into debates after debates with people on Twitter that follow me. And I don't have any issues having a debate. The debate is fine. That, like, oh, Lance Henderson was also killed by all three of these, movie monsters or movie villains. And that's inaccurate. He's run into all three of them, but he has not been killed by all three of them. Lance Henderson was killed in the police station scene in Terminator. Correct. Arnold shot him. He died. Aliens, it's a different story. Bishop, Lance Henderson plays Bishop, the ship's, synthetic android. Bishop is not alive. Bishop is not a living thing. He's an artificial he prefers the term artificial person, is what he says, if I remember it correctly. I prefer the term artificial person myself when they're in the cafeteria scene and he's like squeezing the pee and that white stuff is running down him.
You never said anything about an android being on board. Why not?
It never occurred to me. It's just common practice. We always have a synthetic on board.
I prefer the term artificial person myself. Is there a problem?
He runs into the queen alien. Obviously, the queen messes up his day. He gets, ripped in half and thrown across, but he's not dead. He can't die anyway. He's not actually alive. He's a machine, for all intents and purposes.
I'm sorry if I scared you. That platform was just becoming too unstable. I had to circle and hope that things didn't get too rough to take you off.
Bishop, you did okay.
I did.
Oh, yeah.
The queen gets sucked out. Ripley, Newt, Hicks, and Bishop are, in stasis. They're alive. They're flying home. When Alien 3 starts, they have the facehugger on board. The ship sucks everybody out. And you know, Newt's killed, Hicks is killed, Bishop, they kind of throw him out with the trash. Ripley finds him, and they have a conversation. He replays what happens on the Sulaco, and it tells him, you know, an inanimate object on board or unauthorized person on board or something along those lines.
My legs hurt.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. I'm just a glorified toaster. How are you? Oh, I like your new haircut.
Bishop, can you access data on the flight recorder?
No problem.
He asks to be terminated. He says, I'm not in tip-top shape or something along those, you know, something like that. Ripley agrees to terminate him. She kills him. Now, granted, she has a queen inside her, but she's not an alien herself. And you can't kill someone that's not alive. That sounds like sound logic to me, and I get in these debates every year when I share that with people that are like, oh, Lance Henderson. No, he encountered all three of those species and enemies. And he's killed by a predator in Aliens vs. Predator, that weird movie in Antarctica or wherever it took place at. I can't remember. I saw it in theaters, don't ask me why. I never saw Alien vs. Predator Requiem, but I did see AVP. It's not a bad movie by any means, but it's definitely not good.
Don't turn your back on me.
I mean, Bill Paxton was one of my favorite actors of all time. I tried to see everything that guy did. I mean, I think the first time I saw him was probably in Terminator in the beginning with the blue hair looking all ridiculous with that leader from the guy who turned out to be in X-Files later on. That was like the leader of the aliens that used to stick the needle in the back of the neck. I don't remember what his name is. He played Buffalo Bob and or Buffalo Bill or Buffalo Bob and Dirt Joe Dirt. He showed up randomly in that. But I've tried to get my hands on anything Bill Paxton's ever done. So it's, you know, for me, growing up, it was Aliens, it was Predator. Actually, I didn't see Near Dark until I was probably like 17. And I'm going to share a video at the end of this. It's Lance Henderson, who we were talking about before, telling a story about Bill Paxton on the set of Near Dark. And it's from the 100 Scariest Movie Moments. And it's one of my favorite stories, you know, actor-wise that I've ever heard. It's definitely like, I've never met Bill Paxton, but if I ever did, I'd know this sounds exactly like something Bill would do. It's like 2 minutes long. I'll share it at the end of this. You guys will see. I'll put it up. So, you know, Aliens, Predator, Near Dark. He was in Commando for like 2 seconds with Arnold randomly. Twister was a big one for me in the 90s. I even had the Twister book. So, I mean, Bill was everywhere. One of my favorites in this last, you know, century, I guess, since we've started the 2000s is Broken Lizard's Club Dread. Coconut Pete is one of my favorite characters in movie history, and I remember watching Ebert and Ropert review this movie, and Richard Ropert loved the fact that he was playing like a Jimmy Buffett ripoff or something like that. And he's like, he was so compelling in the role, he was hilarious. Like, you wouldn't expect Bill Paxton to show up in this comedy movie from the guys that made Super Troopers, but he was, and he was amazing in it.
Play Margaritaville.
Excuse me.
Play Margaritaville. I love that song.
Darling, I think you're referring to my song, Pina Colada Berg.
No, Margaritaville.
I think you mean Pina Colada Berg. The song I wrote 7.5 fucking years before Margaritaville was even on the map. Of course, you wouldn't know that because you weren't even born yet.
Come on, Hawkshaw, let's get us a drink.
I don't need to shit.
Come on, man. Fuck that guy, son of a bitch. Motherfucker.
And a friend of mine has pointed out, he's been killed by an alien, a Terminator, and a Predator. And he's also the only person that put Pina Coladaberg on the map 7 years before Jimmy Buffett put Margaritaville on the map. So, I mean, that seems like inarguable logic, and it's what I think. I mean, his career probably slowed down in the 2000s. I mean, he wasn't like the main star of anything besides Big Love. I mean, I never watched it when it was on HBO, but I know he was nominated for a lot of awards, and he was actually in it with Harry Dean Stanton for a couple seasons, who was, you know, in the first Alien movie. I never watched Big Love. I don't know why, it just wasn't something that I got into, but you know, when you get into this century, it's been Club Dread, Vertical Limit, because I love climbing movies. I mean, you don't really have that many of them. It's usually, you know, Cliffhanger, Vertical Limit, that I know of. I mean, if there's any other awesome climbing movies out there, send them my way. I'll definitely check them out. I know he was in that Tom Cruise movie, Live, Die, Repeat, or Edge of Tomorrow. That's what it was called. I keep calling it by the alternate title. You know, he was the drill sergeant in that. He actually played like... So, I mean, when you see Hudson in Aliens, he's like this, you know, smart-ass private, always going up against Sergeant Apone, kind of like rebelling against the rules. And then when you see him in Edge of Tomorrow, he's like, you know, the straight-edge drill sergeant trying to get everybody to fall in line and listen up. That's just totally not who he was in the 80s, but it's who he is now. I remember he was in U-571. He was the captain of that ship. And, like, I didn't know he was in the movie going into it. I just remember they got the U-boat, they rolled up, then they're like, okay, everything's fine. Then they're just blown up by a torpedo and you never saw him again. The last thing I saw him in, I was a huge fan. So he was in Marvel Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. in the first season. He was awesome in that. Obviously, when I was watching, I did not expect to see Bill Paxton show up in this, you know, ABC Marvel show, but he did, and he was incredible in the first season. But the last season, the last thing I saw him do was that Training Day show on CBS. You're thinking, okay, like, you know, Denzel did Training Day, Ethan Hawke did Training Day, the movie. What could this show be like? And it was actually really good, and he died right in the middle, I think it was 2017, so it was like, the show was probably just coming back or maybe just about to go on hiatus because it was a mid-season show, and it was like, oh, you got the news that Bill Paxton died. You're like, oh, I don't know. Like, that was shocking news for me when it happened. I didn't think it was real when it happened. I was like, you know, Bill Paxton's only 61 years old. Like, and stuff. But, you know, he ended up having the ailments that he had and he unexpectedly passed away. But Training Day was a really good show, and it's only a couple episodes. I don't think they finished the season. You know, I think they did like 8 episodes or something along those lines. And then they never really came back to finish it. But you should check it out, because it's a lot better than anything had the right to be that was not starring Denzel and Ethan Hawke. But, yeah, I just wanted to do that video for Bill. I meant to do it on Sunday. I didn't get a chance to. You know, Bill Paxton, one of my favorite actors. He'll always be one of my favorite actors. He's in everything that I love. And, you know, officially it's... and I don't want to say it because it's sad, but game over, man. Game over. And check back. I'm going to put that video up of Near Dark.
Bill Paxton called me up and said, Lance, I know about this script. It's a great script. And I said, well, what is it, Bill? He said, it's a vampire western. And I said, oh, come on, Bill. God's sake. It sounded like the worst movie I ever heard of. And then I got the script and read it, and I couldn't believe it.
It's kind of a cross-genre film. It mixes together elements from horror, westerns, the road movie.
I thought of ourselves as nocturnal nomads.
Lance Henriksen in Near Dark was the leader of this vampire group who ride around in this van that windows are all blacked out.
And when they attack people, it's a wicked, full-blown, raw attack.
The movie's also celebrating their immortality in a way.
We felt like we never attacked anybody that didn't have it coming. Like low lives and people that were trying to carjack us, or, you know, we kind of laid the bait out, and anybody that took it paid.
The scariest scene was Bill Paxton's in this bar, and, you know, there's all these bikers and stuff, and the whole crew's in there, and then they start messing with him, whatever, and Bill Paxton just starts ripping these guys apart.
Trouble with your hog leg,
had this makeup where his head was busted open and it was wide open. He was covered with blood. And every night at the same time, his train would pull into town and stop right in the intersection. So this guy come walking out of the train, out of the diesel thing, and Billy walked up to him and said, "Hey, man, there's been an accident." And he says, "If you think I'm bad, wait till you see the other guy."